as fast as I could.
It's about time.
Well, I'm sorry, but I didn't check with my message service just a little while ago that I had to dig up a taxi cab.
Called you six times.
Well, I know. What's the emergency? I would have phoned you to find out, but I didn't want to take the time. You know, when the girl said urgent, boy, I didn't dilly-dally.
Been waiting for you for almost 2 hours.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Now, listen, Dan, you got nothing to worry about. Whatever it is, I can handle it. I got influential connections all over the city. Now, what's the emergency?
I was lonesome.
Would you like a punch in the nose?
Louise, haven't you ever been lonesome? It's a terrible feeling.
I should have known. You just closed at the Copa after 11 smash weeks, and now because you're between bookings, you feel like a lost soul.
Can't help it. I don't know what to do with myself.
Danny, why don't you learn to relax? Look at you. You're all tense. Your nerves are tied up in knots.
What's wrong with that? A fella could be pretty sloppy going around with loose nerves. Actually, I'm nervous, but I'm neat.
If that's a joke you're thinking of using in a new routine, drop it now.
Look, Liz, let's face it. Show business is my whole life. And here it is, 2 weeks before my next club engagement.
Oh, that's horrible. 2 whole weeks before you can spend every night in a smoke-filled saloon? Oh, Dan. Better?
Got you something?
Can't have your lungs getting used to fresh air.
All right, never mind. Come on. Center point.
Okay.
Hi, Aunt Liz.
Oh, hi, Russ.
Hello, Daddy. Whoop. Dear.
Hiya, Rusty dear.
Gee, Daddy, you taste smoky.
Well, thank you very much.
You're the most wonderful daddy in the whole world.
Well, those are the most wonderful words in the whole world. Do you know I just thrive on that kind of language from you?
I bet no kid ever had a daddy as nice as you.
No, if you don't cut this out, you're gonna have my head as big as a balloon.
Daddy, can I ask you a big favor?
Just busted the balloon. I might have known there was a reason for all this smooching. What's the big favor?
Well, the school is having an awards party this Friday night in the auditorium, and the principal would like you to entertain.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Ross.
What do you mean, oh, now, wait a minute? It's your chance to go back to work. Of course, your lungs may rebel against the fresh air of a school auditorium, but you'll have an audience.
You call those kids an audience? I played PS 54 last year. Those kids aren't an audience. They're a convention of grasshoppers. Every 5 seconds, one of them pops up for a drink of water. I never saw so many dry kids in my whole life. And with the spitballs and the bubble gum, blowing bubble gum in the first number alone, there were 35 blowouts. I'm sorry, my nerves can't take it anymore, son.
Well, okay, if you don't want to be there and see me get a special award.
Oh, now, wait a minute. You getting an award?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you say so? I'm proud of you.
Thanks.
How about that, Liz?
Hey, congratulations, Ross.
Well, I guess if my son is getting an award, his old dad ought to be there to see it.
Sure. You mean you'll entertain?
You bet I will.
Oh, boy. Thanks, Daddy. I'll go tell the principal I booked you.
Well, Ross, wait a minute. What are you getting the award for?
For getting you to entertain.
That kid.
You ought to be happy. On Friday night, you've got an audience.
Yeah, but this year I'm taking my own spitballs and fighting back. Hello. Oh, hi, Jess. What? Would I? When? This weekend? Well, that means I'd have to fly out tomorrow. All right. I'll see you in your office later in the day, this afternoon. Well, she's right here. I'll bring her with me. Okay.
What's
up? Hey, how about that? Jack and Trotter got a mix-up in his bookings at the Sands Hotel, and it needs me to fill in Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. I'd have to fly out tomorrow to Vegas. Gee, that's great. You know, it comes at a wonderful time. I mean, it's kind of a vacation with pay, don't you think? Don't you think it's... What's the matter?
Haven't you got a little mix-up in bookings yourself?
What are you talking about?
Aren't you booked into PS 54 Friday night?
Oh, gosh, I forgot all about it. Oh, but this is business. I mean, Rusty will understand.
I'm not so sure. He just went to tell the principal. Those kids are counting on you.
Oh, Liz, he's an intelligent boy. All I gotta do is sit him down and explain it to him. He'll understand.
Sit him down and explain it to him, huh?
Of course. All I do is look and I just say, sit down, Sonny. Now, listen, you know that I was gonna do the show for you. I promised to do it. But you see, something came up. I have to go to Las Vegas over the weekend. I won't be able to do the show. And you know what he'll say to me?
Daddy, you're a stinker.
Rush, you don't understand what happened.
I sure do. You made a promise and now you're breaking it.
I'm not breaking the promise. Breaking a promise means that you deliberately don't want to do something you said you would want. You see, I'm not doing that. A job came up and I gotta work, you know. I'm a performer. I'll go stale.
That's why I booked you into PS54. We're giving you the top spot, too. Right after the fourth grade girls do the dance of the flowers.
Well, I appreciate it very much, son, but there's a big difference between the show at PS54 and the Sands Hotel.
The only difference is our chorus girls are shorter.
All right.
All I know is you made a promise and now you're breaking it just because you don't like kids.
That's not true. I do like kids.
Then prove it.
Look, Russ, I play the Sands Hotel twice a year. It's like an annuity for me. Now they're in trouble. They need my help. I can't slough them off.
But you can slough me off. I ask you to do me a teensy-weensy favor and you won't do it. I might as well not have a father. I might as well be an orphan.
Now, Russ.
You're supposed to be a father and a mother to me. Boy, have you been goofing.
I haven't been goofing.
You don't care about me.
I do so.
Then how come you put me on a spot like this? I told all the kids you were going to entertain, and now I have to tell them you're backing out.
Rusty, the Sands Hotel is very important.
Sure, and I'm not important. You don't care about me. You're the only parent I got, and you don't care. I might as well be an orphan.
Oh, stop saying that.
True, I might as well be an orphan.
I said stop saying that. Now, listen to you, young man. I won't stand for that kind of talk from my own son.
I'm not your son. I'm disowning you.
See here, young fella. I haven't taken a strap to you for a long time. But you are trying my patience. Now, go on upstairs.
Okay, but you and I are finished.
That's fine. My lawyer will call a lawyer and dissolve the partnership.
Might as well be an orphan.
Don't say that!
Dear Daddy, we're finished. No, that doesn't sound good. Dear ex-daddy, we're finished because you don't care about me anymore. Goodbye forever, your loving son, Rusty. Your loving ex-son, Rusty.
I've notified the police, too. I'm sorry to bother you. Well, thank you. Well, look, if you hear from them, you will let me... Well, thanks. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Ex-loving son. No luck, huh?
Went to every candy store, went to the neighborhood movie, went up and down the aisles, no Rusty.
Where can he be? Hey, you don't suppose he went to Aunt Hannah's to be with Terry?
No. Where would he get the money to go to Philadelphia?
Yeah, you're right. Why would he do a thing like this to me? Why?
You really asking?
Get off of my back, will you? All right. So I made a mistake. I needed those 3 days at the Sands like I needed a hole in my head. I'm going out and look for him.
Again, Danny, you've been out 6 times already.
I gotta find him, don't I? He's just a baby and it's getting dark. He probably huddled in some corner, cold and scared. He's my boy, after all. I gotta find him.
Mr. Williams?
Yes?
I'm Mrs. Martin. I'd like to speak to you for a minute. May I come in?
Look, come some other time, will you, lady? I'm very busy.
I was sure you would be. Perhaps if you weren't quite so busy, my visit here would be unnecessary.
Well, look, this is Miss O'Neill, my press agent. She'll take care of you.
I came here to talk to you.
Look, lady, please, I don't want to be rude, but whatever you're selling, I haven't got time to buy.
I'm trying to sell you your son.
What? Where is he?
Mr. Williams, I'm from the West End home. A few hours ago, your son applied for admission as an orphan.
How could you admit him? He's not an orphan, he's my son.
He didn't say he was your son.
He didn't?
No. He said his name was Elvis Earp. His little bag, she unpacked it and found his real name and address in one of the books.
How do you like that? My son is an orphan. My flesh and blood declares himself an orphan.
All right, so he's an orphan. Go down and adopt him.
I got no time for jokes.
Why didn't you bring him with you, Miss Martin?
Oh, Mr. Williams, when a boy does what your son has done, he must be deeply disturbed about something. I don't think it would solve anything to drag him back here.
You're not certainly going to let him stay there.
Well, of course not. But just bringing him home would be treating the result and ignoring the cause. Why did he run away?
Sit down, Mrs. Martin.
Thank you.
By the way, how is he? Is he all right?
He's quite all right. No thanks to his father.
Look, please, let's not judge people before we know the facts, huh? We just had a little misunderstanding, that's all. I made a promise to him, and then I broke the promise.
Oh?
I had to break it, you understand? I didn't mean to. It just turned out that way.
So then he felt that he couldn't trust his father. He felt insecure.
I had a logical excuse for breaking the promise. I tried to explain it to him.
But a child doesn't listen to words or logic, Mr. Williams. He has to know that he's needed and loved.
Loved? Look, lady, when it comes to loving my kids, I'm the corniest bum that ever walked. That's what's the matter. I love him too much, and he knows it. That's why he's doing this to me. He figures he'll wait till he's got me worried half to death, then he'll show up, and I'll be so happy to see him, he can have his own way.
Then you mean this whole thing is just an act?
In three parts with two intermissions.
I'll admit, kids can be pretty brutal.
You're telling me, especially my kids.
I still say, go down and adopt him.
Hey. You got something. Come along, Miss Martin. We have business at your orphanage.
Liz, you call off the bloodhounds.
Listen, I was just kidding. I don't think you can adopt your own son.
I know that, but before I'm through, he's gonna adopt me.
So how long have you been here?
Too long.
What do you mean?
Well, this adoption business is kind of tricky. You gotta swing it before you're six, while you're still cute. I wasn't even cute when I was six.
children, gather around. Come along here. Now, ever since we started our Father's Weekend program, we've been fortunate enough to receive visits from many distinguished people. And tonight, even though it's almost bedtime, I have a wonderful surprise for you. A very famous entertainer was passing by our home, and the subject of children was on his mind. So he thought it would be nice to come in and meet you and say hello to you. And here he is, Mr. Danny Williams. Yay!
Hiya, kids.
Hi.
Now that he's here, maybe we can get him to tell us a story or sing a song for us.
Oh, come on, sing a song.
Well, certainly. I'm very, very happy to be here. As a matter of fact, I like to entertain kids. I'd like to sing a little song for you. Oh, it's a real old song. It was popular when I was a little boy. And, I want to dedicate this song to a very special little fella. Goes like this. I can be happy. I can be sad. I can be good. Or I can be bad.
It all depends on you. I could be lonesome out in a crowd. I could be humble. I could be proud. It all depends on you. I could make money or spend it, go on living or end it. You're to blame, Sonny, for what I do. You know, this little fella I'm singing about, when he was just a small boy, oh, been in school only a couple of years, he came home one day and he said, "Hey, Dad, I got a no from school." He says, "I got a no. What's the biggest city in the United States?" And I said, "I don't know." He said, "What's the biggest river in the United States?" I said, "I don't know." He said, "What's the largest capital city in the world?" I said, "I don't know." He said to me, "Gee, Daddy, I hope you don't mind my asking all these questions." I said, "Oh, no. How else can you learn anything?" But one time he came home from Sunday school and he says to me, "Gee, Dad, today at Sunday school, they said something about dust thou art, to dust thou shalt return. Is that true? What does that mean?" And I said, "Well, son, according to the Bible, man is made of dust. We're all made of dust. And after a long and happy life, we go back to dust. You see? You come from dust, and you go back to dust." He said, "Oh, yeah? You better hurry upstairs and look under the bed, because somebody's either coming or going." It's not always fun between the boy and me, but glad or sad, he's the whole world to me. And you see, I could make money or spend it, go right on living or end it. You're to blame, Sonny, for what I do. Say, I could be a beggar, I could be a king. Gosh, I could be almost any old thing. It all depends on you.
Time. That's all we can have for tonight.
I'll tell you what, kids. I'll come back again.
Oh, please do. Come back soon.
Anytime you need an extra weekend, Father, you just call.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Williams. Thank you.
Not at all.
Now, to bed, boys. Here we go.
Good night, guys. I'll be seeing you soon now.
Goodbye. Good night, boys.
Bye.
Good night.
Bye. Goodbye. Come, you're not going to bed. Rusty, what are you doing here?
My name's not Rusty, it's Elvis Earp.
Elvis Earp?
That's right, I'm an orphan.
I see you're talking to Elvis. He's rather new here.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Martin. The joke is a joke, but I know my own son. I thought you were home sleeping.
I was your son, but now I want to be an orphan.
Hey. You sound serious. You mean you really want to be an orphan?
That's right.
Oh. Well, that's something else again. I thought you were just kidding about all this, but see, now you're not. Look, Miss Martin, I love my son very much, and I certainly want him to be happy, and if you'll be happier living here than at home with me, well, then I don't want to stand in his way. Of course, it'll be kind of lonesome or the house without a little boy around, but...
Get a dog.
Well, Yeah, and maybe I should. Well, goodbye, Miss Martin.
Of course, I wouldn't have to be an orphan if somebody in my family cared about me.
That's true.
Well, maybe so, but I don't have time to discuss it, Miss Martin. I'm a very, very busy man. I have a lot of rehearsing to do. I have an important show to put on Friday night at PS 54. Well, goodbye.
Daddy, you mean you're not going to Las Vegas? You're going to entertain at school?
Of course I'm going to entertain at school. Kids are counting on me. Well, goodbye, Wyatt Presley.
Miss Wyatt Presley.
Oh, excuse me, Elvis Earp.
It isn't Elvis Earp. It's Rusty.
Okay, goodbye, Rusty.
What do you mean, goodbye? I'm going with you.
Oh, no, you're not.
Why not? You're gonna do the show now. I forgive you.
Oh?
Everything's all right now.
Oh, everything is all right now, but if something goes wrong tomorrow, you'll be running off again. No, I'm sorry. I couldn't take that chance. Well, I sure hope you'll find him a father that he likes.
Oh, but I thought you wanted to have a little boy around the house.
Well, yes, I do, but it's got to be a certain kind of a little boy. You keep your eyes open for one, will you? Tell you what kind I want. He's got to, well, he's got to stand about 4 feet four. He's got to have curly hair and blue eyes.
Daddy, that's me.
Well, just a moment, please. I haven't finished describing the boy I want. This boy that I want can never say to his father, I'm not your son anymore, no matter what. And he's not to keep saying, you don't love me anymore, you don't love me anymore, every time something goes wrong or doesn't go his way. I want a boy who's got to understand that if I have responsibilities as a father, he has responsibilities as a son. A boy who if he expects love and consideration, is willing to give it in return. Now, you find me such a boy, and I'll adopt him in a minute. Take good care of him, Mrs. Martin.
I promise, Daddy. Cub Scouts on.
Come on home, you little monkey. What do you say we celebrate?
Oh, boy.
Let's go out and do the town. We'll go to the movies, and after the movies, we'll stop and have a nice double chocolate ice cream soda. Then we'll go home, and I'll break every bone in your body.
Go to the movies, Joey. Let's play. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Wowee. Huh? Oh, sure. My dad will let me go.
Let you go where?
Just a minute, Joey. To the movies. Can I?
What's playing?
A terrific triple feature. The Creature from the Black Lagoon, The Monster from the Deep, and Frankenstein Meets the Bloodsuckers.
Yeah? And what's the cartoon? Donald Duck Eats Dracula? Well, you can't go. I don't want you seeing those kind of movies.
But, Daddy, all the other kids are going.
I don't care about the other kids.
Well, their fathers don't mind.
Well, your father does mind. Do you mind?
You don't love me.
What did you say?
You don't love me. If you love me, you'd let me go. All the other kids' fathers are letting them go, and my father won't let me go. You don't love me. I might as well be an orphan for a... I've decided not to go, Joe. You know something, Daddy? You ought to start wearing suspenders.